Now, have you guys updated the forecast for the car industry in the year 2021 yet?
Actually, we just recently sort of took a full look at the numbers again, and we have not adjusted our forecast. However, we have a bit of updated assumptions, if you will. The first thing is the market overall came in at 1.53 million last year.
That's a 25% drop, no?
That's a 20% drop, and in
Okay.
Ontario it's 23%, right, for the year. So that's actually a bigger drop than in the financial crisis of 2018. That's what a lot of people sort of forget, right? Okay, it didn't drop 60% as some people thought when we're, staring into the abyss in April, right, of
That's
last year.
right.
But nevertheless, it's still down 20%. Now, so it came in a little bit lower even than our expectation of 1.6 that we had for last year. For this year, we are forecasting 1.8 a million for the market. However, we've always said that there's upside and downside to that forecast. The upside is obviously if, vaccine rollouts move along very quickly and we have economic recovery programs from the government in place in the second half of the year, then, there might be an upside to that number. However, there's now also a downside, and let's say the probability of some of those downside effects happening to the 1.8 have now just gone up in the last couple of weeks because of A, there's still, I would say, a bit of uncertain a vaccine rollout. And the
It's a
second
mess.
piece.
Tim, it's just a mess. Let's call it for what it is. We'll run out of vaccine, I think. I don't see that that happening anytime soon, and that is affecting all the internal forecasts for most car manufacturers. So, I mean, there's got to be a really downside to this the lack of or the inefficiency in the rollout of the vaccines, no?
And the second piece, as you know, is the product shortage that we're starting to see and we'll see in the coming months, depending on how long the supply chains are from each manufacturer, due to the electronic chip shortage, right?
That's
That we
right.
have worldwide. So, and that's going to affect, by the way, different brands at different times, right? Those that have a short supply chain are going to be affected almost immediately now, right? Those that have a longer supply chain of, let's say, 2 months because the vehicles are coming from Asia or from Europe, won't feel it for another 2 months.